In this video, I will be showing you step by step how to integrate your Autogen agents made in Autogen Studio directly into your website. In my previous video, I did a full walk through Autogen Studio and built multiple agents to fetch YouTube comments and generate content ideas. If you haven't watched it yet, I would highly recommend you to watch it after this video. You will find the link in the description. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding of how to add your own custom Autogen agents into any website. And for that, I'm going to show you two different methods. The first one is through a chatbot with Voiceflow, and the second one is a direct integration into HTML and CSS. They both do not require a lot of technical background, as I will provide you with a step-by-step tutorial. You will just need to download the code and change it a little bit, and you are good to go. Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Donna, and I am an AI specialist based in Sydney. I'm helping entrepreneurs and professionals to learn more about using and building AI solutions. I also created a Discord to discuss everything related to AI, Autogens, OpenAI, etc., etc. It's 100% free, and you will find the link in the description of the video. And in there, you will find all the links of the Voiceflow, Replit, etc. that I have been using in this specific video. So I would highly recommend you to join it. Assume that you made a workflow on Autogen Studio and you want to share it with your friends, colleagues, or clients. And there isn't a clear way to do it from the interface itself, but don't worry, I got you covered. The first step will be to create an API that will run the workflow that you have built with Autogen Studio. And the second step will be to call that API and use it inside either Voiceflow or your own custom website. So now I'm back into Autogen Studio on the workflow and build tab. And if I click here, I can directly download the workflow as a JSON file. This is exactly what I'm gonna do now. And then I can save it into my download. So now I open this into Visual Studio Code. And I clicked right and format documents to having it like this. What you can see is that all of my API keys are exposed. Like here, for example, you can see my OpenAI API key. So what I want to do is to replace all of these keys by another thing that is something like this. So here I will do this and write down OpenAI API key, and I will close it as well. Later in this video, I will show you how to replace all of these symbols by the key itself. So here I will update it here, and I will also update it here, and also the YouTube API keys that I have here. And for that, I will use the similar syntax, which would be like this, YouTube API key. Now that I've done that, I can go to Replit and I can directly import that file. In this case, we want to send a video ID and get back a list of video topics that I can make. So now I can go on Replit and I can import my JSON file. So here in the main.py file, I have all of my logic to create the API. And as we can see here, I'm creating a post API that is called run workflow. And that API will take as parameter workflow parameters. So this is a class that I created that contains all of the different parameters that I will need in my call. So in this case, I need my YouTube video ID, and that's a string. So if I go back to my main.py file, as we can see here, I am loading the agent, so the workflow.json file. I'm creating the workflow config, and then I'm creating the workflow. After that, I have task query, which is the query that I have created and that I replace some of the elements into it with my YouTube video ID. So in this case, it's based on the YouTube video with the ID that I get from the API, which cover how to build an AI assistant, generate a list of new video content ideas. So this is the prompt that I'm using, and this is the parameter that is going to be replaced. And then I can directly run that workflow here. Once I run it to get the response, I will just look at the agent history, take the last item, take the message and the content of the last message. And I will put all of that into the response that I will return from the API. In my function load agent specs, I have multiple things that I'm doing. And if I check the utils, because that's where the function is, we can see that here is where I replace all of the API keys. So in order to run the API, as we will see right now, I need to add all of this API key in my secrets. So if we go here on the left to the secrets, as you can see here, I added my OpenAI API key and I also added my YouTube API key. Once I add them here, they will be automatically replaced in the JSON file. So now if I click on run, I can see that my API is running. So now it's loaded, but as you can see here, it says detail not found, but that's not important. What I want to get is I want to get the prefix. So I go to new tab. So now that it opens here, I can directly add here run underscore workflow. And that's going to be the API that we're going to call in the voice flow or in the website integration. I will add a link in the Discord, link in the description of this video to summarize step by step what you need to do to apply it to your own project or use case. Now let's use that API in our chatbot on VoiceFlow. Before jumping into VoiceFlow, please leave a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. I will be publishing a lot of videos like this one about VoiceFlow, AutoGen, OpenAI, etc., etc. Let me know in the comments what you are currently building with AutoGen and if you have any AI topic you want me to dive deeper in. So here I create a really basic VoiceFlow where I have only three blocks. The first block is to ask for the YouTube video ID right here. So here I use a capture block to capture that inside the variable. The second block here is to create a post request. Here I just use the link that I was talking about before and I select post here because it's a post request. Then I have to set up some headers. So here I say content type application/json. And finally, I have raw here where I put the JSON structure that I have. So here I have my parameter and I have the value of that parameter right next to it. When I use these brackets here, I use the VoiceFlow variable that I just captured before. And finally, under that, I capture the response and I set it up to another variable, which is last response. And in the last block, I just have to show last response like this. So now that I have my flow, I can test it. So for that, I can go on the top right on share and on open link in a new tab. Once I click here, it will open automatically the voice flow and create it. So this is something that you can share with your clients when you want to show them your chatbot. Here I can click on start conversation and directly start the conversation. And it asks me to give the ID of the YouTube video. So in this case, I can directly paste the ID here. Enter it and then it will automatically fetch the replit and return the list of all of the different content ideas from that ID. So here, based on your comments from the YouTube videos with the ID, here are some new video content ideas that could be generated. And now I have my list. So this called AutoGen and GPT-4 in the background through the replit to generate the response. Now let's see how to build it directly on your website like this. So now if I want to integrate into my website, like here, I can have the following HTML that will generate that view on the left. Like I have an input here that has the ID, video ID. Then I have a button that is calling generate ideas when it is pressed. If you look at the JavaScript down there, in here, I just get back the video ID from the input. I also have a response container to show the response. So here I get the reference to it. Finally, I do my API call here where I add the content type application/json, like the same as on VoiceFlow. And finally here I add my parameters, which is in this case YouTube video ID with the video ID that I got from the input that I got here. And then I can just wait for the response and pass it into JSON and show that response inside the response container with this code here. This MD block here is just a library that I used to show it with Markdown. So now I can put the video ID here in the input and click on generate ideas and it will automatically return me the response from the server as well. I know that this is a bit more technical as it requires some coding skills. If you don't know how to code, you can paste the code in ChatGPT and ask it to explain it to you or do some changes. This is actually how I built that page. And simply tell what changes you want it to do and copy paste it to update the file. Now you're able to add your own AutoGen agents inside any website, rather in a chatbot or with a direct integration. If you like this type of content, please leave a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.